Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome back, fight fans. Welcome back. Let's just dig right into it. Manny Pacquiao beats Keith Thurman in a split decision. It was a very interesting fight. You know, starting out early in the fight, Keith Thurman came out very aggressive, looking to land a lot of power shots, looking, you know, to try to take Manny Pacquiao's head off. And, you know, as he kept coming in, Manny Pacquiao kept clipping him here and there until eventually Manny Pacquiao got him going back and, you know, caught him, dropped him, and hurt Keith Thurman. So that was a very interesting turn of events. Ever since that point, Keith Thurman kept continuing to be very aggressive, at least through the first 5-6 rounds. You know, he didn't look to just box and move as we normally see Keith Thurman. Keith Thurman looked to be ultra aggressive, ultra, you know, to the point of just looking for one or two big shots, you know, just to end Manny Pacquiao, to stop Manny Pacquiao, to beat Manny Pacquiao. And he was looking for the knockout too early, too often, and that's why he gave away too many early rounds, and that's why he lost tonight. Keith Thurman gave away too many early rounds. Keith Thurman came on later in the fight. Manny Pacquiao hurt Keith Thurman to the body later in the fight. Manny Pacquiao showed that he can still compete at a high level. He showed that he can still compete with young fighters in their prime, and this was a fantastic performance by Manny Pacquiao. You can take nothing away from Manny. This was a great win. And you know, when I analyzed the fight initially, I thought it was a 50-50 fight, and I thought that Manny would either win by knockout or Keith by decision. And so my prediction was ultimately wrong. But when I made that prediction, I assumed that Keith Thurman would come out the same way that he normally does, come out looking for a knockout, trying to hurt Manny. But then after the first 2-3 rounds, he would look to box more, stay on the back foot, and use lateral movements. Keith Thurman didn't do that. Keith Thurman tried to headhunt and tried to knock out Manny. He did great body work at time in the fight, but he was too busy looking for the knockout, looking for the counter, looking for the Marquez shot to stop and knock out Manny. Manny pretty much took all of Keith Thurman's best shots and didn't get wobbled, didn't go down, while Keith Thurman looked to be hurt multiple times in the fight. Keith Thurman, and you know, a lot of people say Manny Pacquiao destroyed Keith. That's not the case. This was a much closer fight than what people want to, you know, say it is. Keith Thurman had a very good chance of getting a draw or potentially winning this fight. But the thing is about it is that Keith Thurman, you know, he did a very good job, you know, as far as coming back and winning the rounds, landing power shots, and his connect percentage was better than Manny's. He landed more power shots than Manny, more than any Manny Pacquiao opponent in the history of his career. So Manny Pacquiao and Keith Thurman was a very close competitive fight in the second half of the fight. The first half of the fight, Manny Pacquiao dominated enough, and he did enough the second half of the fight to get the belt, to win the title, and to become the new champion. So at this point, we look forward to see Manny Pacquiao in another big fight. You know, this was a fantastic fight. It was a closer fight than most people thought, but Manny Pacquiao clearly won early and often, and all of his shots landed were very hard, thudding shots, and Keith Thurman seemed to be affected by literally almost every shot that Manny Pacquiao landed. But once again, unbiased as always, it's the IBFP. Please share, like, and you must absolutely subscribe.